bracket connection, that is nothing but eccentric voltage connection. Till now we discussed whichever the problem, it is actually loaded or concentric loaded connection. So I want to analyze this type of connection, so which will be having two types of shear. One is direct shear and one more is a twisting shear. So if I apply the load like this, so it is going to rotate in this direction. So in opposite to that, we have opposite to that P, we have direct shear, and in that twisting direction, perpendicular to from CG to that twisting, we have one more force. We will call it as a twisting shear. So we'll denote it as FM, and a direct shear we will denote it as FP. So FP directly load divided by number of bolt, we can calculate, that is FP. We can see here. For calculating FM, that is a twisting shear, we did one small derivation. So FM can be calculated M into R max divided by sigma R square. So R max is the distance to the critical bolt in that particular section. So if you see here, in this particular section, if I take this example, this will be the critical bolt which is having at a farthest distance, okay, longest distance. So we have four bolts. We can see here, these are all critical bolt. Four bolts are at a farthest distance. I can consider any one bolt, then I can find R maximum. Okay, so if I get FM and FP value, I can use a parallelogram law of first year which we studied, that is resultant can be given by root of FP square plus FM square plus 2FP FM cos theta. You studied it as P and Q, here it is FP and FM. So whatever the value we are going to get, it should be greater than bolt value. So in this P is the bracket load and E is the eccentricity from CG. Okay, whatever the eccentricity, that we have to find the center of gravity. Sometimes in the problem they will give like this E value. So directly if you take that, it is wrong. From CG, so CG is the entire bolt. If I take set of bolt here, six number of bolt, CG is here. So if it is symmetry, directly I can calculate. If it is not symmetry, I have to use the formula of CG, center of gravity, what we studied in first year. Then E is the eccentricity from CG, and G is the gauge distance, that is the distance between two rows. Okay, vertically if you measure, that is gauge distance. R max, as I said, distance to the extreme bolt. Then we discussed design procedure or design step. So calculate the bolt value. So in the normal bolt, till now we discussed black bolt or normal bolt. Sometimes they will give in the exam black bolts. So that time you have to use the same procedure. In that bolt value is the minimum of shear strength of the bolt and bearing strength of the bolt. HSFG bolt, high strength friction grip bolt, that I will discuss in the third problem. In that bolt value, directly shear strength of the bolt. Okay, how to calculate shear strength of the HSFG bolt, I will explain in the third problem of bracket connection. Okay, in that I am going to cover HSFG bolt, also bracket connection type. Okay, so once I get the bolt value, we have to consider lap joint. So locate a CG, that is the third step, then find FP, find R maximum, FM, that is the twisting shear, M into R maximum divided by sigma R. Then find the theta, it is the angle between FP and FM. So once you find the theta, I can find R value by using the parallelogram law of forces. The number of bolt, N is equal to root of 6M divided by N dash into P into R. So N is the number of bolt in single row. If you see here, we have two rows usually. Okay, so whatever the value I'm going to get, That is the number of bolt in single row. If I get 3, that is in single row, that is the number of bolt. Okay, then one more thing, that is n dash, that is the number of rows, usually 2 rows. Okay, n dash is the number of rows. M is the moment, that is P into E. And small letter P is the pitch distance. Okay, usually it is 2.5 into D. 2.5 into D. So R is the bolt value. So if you remember, you have to remember this formula. It is not available in the code book. N is equal to root of 6M divided by N dash into P into R. So let us start with this problem. Take down this problem. Bracket bolted vertical column subjected to load P as shown in figure. If M20 grade bolt of 4.6 grade are used in the connection, determine the maximum value of factored load P which can be carried safely. So they're not given a P value. So if I use 5 number of bolt in this pattern, so what will be the load it can carry? Okay, that is the question. This type of problems will be asked. Or else sometimes they will give the load value, P value. So for that, we have to calculate the number of bolt. So that is one more type of problem. Okay, I will start with the solution. So first thing, we have to note down some of the data in this. E is equal to, that is the eccentricity, they given 250 mm. So this is the data they given in the question, whatever they given as it is, I'm going to note down here. So this is the eccentricity. Then I can find G. So G is equal to 120 mm. So also I can find E value. So totally they given 300 mm. So this will be the E value. So total width is 300 minus 120. Okay. So divided by 2 will give the E value. So from 300, if I deduct 120, remaining is this one. Okay, divided by 2 will give the E value. So 90 mm is the E value. So 90 mm is the E value. So these are the basic things which they given. So I'm going to start with resultant, or if you go back to the thing, whatever the resultant in the design type of problem, I have to check against bolt value. But in this case, I have to find the P value. I have to find the load. Okay, therefore, I'm going to substitute R is equal to bolt value. Okay, you'll get the what is the difference between this type of problem and a design type of problem once I start with the other problems. Okay, but in this case, I'm going to take resultant is equal to bolt value. So therefore, resultant is equal to root of FP square plus FM square plus 2 FP FM cos theta. Okay, this is the formula for R. So therefore, I have to find this R and bolt value. If I substitute each other, I can find the value of P. Okay, to find R, I'm going to start with FP is equal to P by N, isn't it? We know that direct shear FP is equal to P by N. In this, we don't know the value of P, but I know what is the value of N. So N is equal to how much? How many number of volts are available here? five number of bolts. So we can see directly we have five number of bolts totally. So I'm going to take n is equal to 5. So I don't know what is p. Therefore, I'm going to substitute here p divided by 5 is equal to 0.2 p. Next, I'm going to calculate fm. So what is the formula for fm? So we have the formula m into r maximum divided by summation of r square. So r maximum, if you see in the question, that is the distance to the critical bolt. We have four critical bolt. If I find for one bolt, that is more than enough. Okay, therefore, how to find that r maximum? So I'm going to take in the diagram, this will be the r maximum, isn't it? It is the distance from the CG. Since it is a symmetry, directly I can take, this is the center of gravity of all the bolts. So since it is symmetry in x direction and y direction, directly I can take middle bolt is the CG of this particular connection. Okay, so from CG to the critical bolt, that is the farthest bolt, that is the r maximum value. So if I want to find that value, so I can use like this. This is the CG, so this is the critical bolt. Okay, so now in the vertical direction we have the distance total, it is 160, they given, you can see here. Okay, I'm going to take it as 80. Then in the horizontal direction they given 120. Okay, distance between two bolts, that is 120. So half of that I'm going to take, that is 60. Okay, 80 and 60 from CG. So one more bolt is here, that is not required, but my intention is to find r maximum. So for that I can use the Pythagoras theorem. So that is nothing but root of 60 square plus 80 square, 100 mm. So one more thing I have to calculate in the denominator, that is sigma r square. So that is the summation of r square. So we have five bolts, summation of r square. So I will consider for my reference this as first bolt, second, third, later I'm going to erase just for your understanding, second, third and fifth, later I'm going to erase. So for the first bolt, what is the distance from CG? So first bolt I have taken center. So CG is is there only. So therefore, for the first bolt, distance is 0. Therefore, 0 square plus, if I see other bolt, for the second bolt, again it is 100 is the distance, isn't it? I have taken this as my second bolt. So for that, from CG, R is what? This is the distance from CG to the bolt. For the second bolt, 100 is the distance. For the third bolt, again 100 is the distance. For the fourth bolt, again 100 is the distance. Fifth bolt, 100 is the distance. So I can do 100 square plus 100 square four times, or else I'm going to take 4 into 100 square, 40,000. So now I have almost all the values in the FM. So FM is equal to, what is M? That is P into E, isn't it? M is nothing but P into E. I'm going to substitute here. I don't know what is P, so I will substitute as it is. Instead of E, what is the eccentricity in this problem? That is 250. At the beginning, we have noted M into
P into E, P into 250 into R maximum we got 100 divided by sigma R square is 40,000. So I will get FM in terms of P, 0.625. So this is the FM value. So I got FP value, FM value. Then I'm going to find R value. Okay, so to find R value, I want the angle between FP and FM, isn't it? I want a theta. What is that theta? It is the angle between FP and FM. So I want to find theta. So I'm going to take a critical bolt. This is my critical bolt here. So from CG is here. So I know that FM is acting perpendicular to the R maximum. That is our assumption, isn't it? So whatever the twisting shear, that is going to act perpendicular to the lever arm, that is R maximum. So then FP is acting against the load. FP is acting against the load. FM is acting perpendicular to the R maximum. Okay, so I can find the angle between FP and FM is theta. So that is my intention, is to find. So for that, I know that this is 90. So I can take this as 90 minus theta, isn't it? So angle between R maximum and FM is 90. So angle between FP and FM is theta. So remaining I can take 90 minus theta. I know the opposite side as well as adjacent side. I can use tan theta rule, isn't it? Okay, so what is this base? That is 60. What is this height? 80. So I got the triangle. So in vertical direction we have 80, in horizontal direction we have 60. So if I use tan 90 minus theta is equal to 60 divided by 80. Okay, so tan inverse of 60 divided by 80, that is 36.86. my intention is to find theta, therefore 90 minus 36.86, so therefore theta is equal to 53.13. so once I get the theta value, now I can substitute in the R equation. I know the value of FM, I know the value of FP, I know the value of theta. So I'm going to substitute here. I will take this as equation one. I'm going to substitute in equation one now. So therefore equation one becomes R is equal to root of FP square. So we calculated FP here, 0.2 P, 0.2 P whole square plus FM square, 0.625 P whole square plus 2 into 0.2 FP into 0.625 P into cos 53.13. Okay, so if I simplify this, I'm going to get R is equal to, if I do again root whatever we got, we will get 0.762 P. Okay, I will keep side. I will take this as equation number 2. So now what is the R value? So my intention is to find P. Now R is nothing but bolt value. So where R is bolt value. So how to find bolt value, which is the minimum of shear strength of the bolt and bearing strength of the bolt. So first we will start with the shear strength of the bolt. So shear strength of the bolt, that is VNSB, is given by Fu divided by root 3 into NS into ASB NN into ANB. So what is the diameter of the bolt they given? They given M20. Okay, if you see the problem, they given M20 bolt. Therefore D is 20 mm. So whether they given, whether it is fully threaded or half threaded, if they given, you can take, or else we have to assume. So therefore I'm going to assume fully threaded bolt. That is the worst condition we can experience in the field, fully threaded. So assume that you have to write. So therefore if I say that fully threaded, as I said, whatever the connection, that will be the lap connection in this type of problem. So I can show the model. You can see the model here. So we have ISMC. Okay, so ISMC they given ISMC 300. So for that we are connecting one bracket plate using 5 number of bolt. Okay, so which is having hole here. Okay, then if I off the gusset plate, this type of connection. So this is clearly, we can say this is lap type of connection. One plate we have here, above that we connected using one more plate. Okay, I'm going to continue now. So as I assumed fully threaded bolt, so lap connection, we understood why we are taking lap connection. So therefore if I take it as fully threaded bolt, simply I'm going to draw just for my reference. So we have the bracket plate here. So we have the bolt. If I take this as fully threaded bolt, where NS is equal to 0, number of non-threaded portion passing through the shear plane, I can take it as 0. I can take NN is equal to 1. That is the number of threaded portion passing through the shear plane. So what is ASB now? So once I get NS and NN value, ASB is equal to, so they give a number dia of the bolt, therefore pi into pi d square divided by 4. ANB is equal to 0.78 times ASB. So ASB is 314.159. And ANB is 0.78 times ASB, that is 245.044. So once I get these values, I can substitute in the equation. So if I substitute in the equation, I'm going to get VNSB, that is FU. What is the grade of bolt they given? 4.6, you can see here. Okay, therefore I have to take 400, 4.6 grade. Therefore 400 FU divided by root 3 into NS is 0. Therefore ASB entire term will become 0. 1 into 245.044. So I will get the value of VNSB. So 56.56 is the Vn Sb kilonewton. So Vd Sb is equal to Vn Sb divided by gamma Mb 45.27 kilonewton. So once I get the shear strength of the bolt, now bearing strength of the bolt. So we know the formula, Vn Pb is equal to 2.5 into Kb into T into D into Fu. Now I have to find what is the minimum T here. So what is the minimum T? So if I go back to the problem, so what is the minimum T value here? So for that I have to refer the steel table. So if I see from the top view, I have ISMC like this. You have seen in the model, I have ISMC like this. So for that we connected our bracket plate. If I see from the top, so we have two thicknesses here. So one is the thickness of the bracket plate. If I see in the problem, that is 10 mm. That is 10 mm. Then we have ISMC 300. So we have to refer what is the dimensions of ISMC 300. So if I see here, it is connected to web of the ISMC 300. This is our ISMC 300. In that, this is flange of the ISMC 300. This is the web of the ISMC 300. So I have to go to the steel table. I have to refer what is the web thickness of the ISMC 300. So we have two thicknesses. So if you go back to the ISMC 300, you can see here, okay, which is having flange thickness, that is 13.6, and web thickness, that is 7.6. Firstly, you should know what is a flange and what is web. So in this case, we whatever the horizontal thing, that is the flange, what is the vertical thing, that is the web. So if you see in that problem, we connected our bracket plate to the web. So I have to refer what is the web thickness, that is thickness of the web. Tw is equal to 7.6. you can see here this value. So that is the thickness of the web, 7.6 mm. Tw, one is from the steel table, that is 7.6. refer steel table. Then one more thickness, we have 10 mm. Therefore I have to consider minimum of these two. So minimum of these two is 7.6 mm. So I got T value. I know what is D value, that is 20 mm. Then I know Fu value. Fu is 400. So I know these values. Now I have to calculate what is Kb. So again we have four formula, E by 3D naught. So one more, P by 3D naught minus 0.25. third value, Fu divided by Fub. So fourth value is 1. So E at the beginning we have taken from the diagram, since we have already have the final diagram or final figure. E we have taken how much? E, that is 90. Okay, so edge distance E, that is 90 mm. So I'm going to consider that 90 mm divided by 3 into D naught is 22, isn't it? For 20 mm dia. Therefore, I can find the first answer. Then second answer, we have to find what is the P here. So in the problem itself, I can find P will be this one. P is equal to 80 mm. Total distance they given 60 mm, but P is 80 mm. So E is equal to 90, P is equal to 80 mm. So I'm going to substitute here. P is 80 divided by 3 into 22 minus 0.25. So third value FU, they not given which type of plate. I'm going to assume 410 divided by 400. So I'll get the 1.36. Okay, some people got the answer 1.36. Then what is the second answer? 0.96. Okay, so third answer is 0.97, fourth answer is 1. 0.96 is the minimum answer. So I can substitute here VNPB is equal to 2.5 into KB, we got 0.96. T we got here, minimum of these two, thickness of the web and thickness of the flange, in that 7.6 is the minimum. Then D is 20 and FU is 400. So we will get VNPB. We got 145.92. So VDPB is equal to VNPB divided by gamma MB. So that is 116.736. So therefore, bolt value is equal to minimum of VDSB and VDPB. So that is, for bolt value is 45.27 kilonewton. So I have taken equation number 2 here. So R is equal to 0.726 for 762P. So where R is the bolt value. So I want to substitute instead of R this 45.27. So I'm going to take equation number 2. So almost we reach the answer. So R is nothing but bolt value. Okay, so therefore 45.27. So I'm going to, from equation number 2, is equal to 0.762P. So I can find the value of P. So what is the P here? 45.27 divided by 0.762. 59.41. So that is not the final answer. So what we have to find? We have to find the safe load. Okay, or design load. So that is nothing but 59.41 divided by 1.5. That is the safe load. Whatever we calculated, that is the factored load. So therefore, safe load or design load, in bracket design load, is equal to whatever the P value divided by 1.5. 39.61 kilonewton is the safe load.